This is another question which involves simple but careful application of the formula tau is equal to I alpha. In this question, we have a rod of 1 kg and 1 meter length. On the two sides of the rod, there are two masses 2 kg and 5 kg attached by strings. We need to find out the initially the rod was horizontal. We need to find out the angular acceleration of the rod and the tensions in the strings joining 2 kg and 5 kg. So let us find out the first part first. Let the angular acceleration be alpha. The angular acceleration, initial angular acceleration of this rod is alpha. So the acceleration of this point, tangential acceleration of this point, that is vertically below, will be alpha by 2, that is alpha into half meters. Now since the initial acceleration of this point is alpha by 2, by string constraint, the initial acceleration of 5 kg mass will be alpha by 2 below. By same logic, the acceleration of this point will be alpha by 2 above and the acceleration of 2 kg mass will be alpha by 2 on the upper side. Now we write the equation, let this be T2 and let this be T1. So we get the equations as 5g minus T2 is equal to 5 alpha by 2. The other equation we get is T1 minus 2g is equal to 2 into alpha by 2, that is mass into acceleration. This is simple Newton's law application in the vertical direction on the two objects. Now there are again three variables, T1, T2 and alpha. So we need to find out one more equation to solve the whole question. Now the third equation which we will get is by this rod. This rod is hinged at its middle. Therefore, we can write the equation, net external torque on the rod is equal to I alpha. We can write this equation about the center point because this is at rest. So always whenever you are writing the equation of torque is equal to I alpha, always write it about a point whose acceleration is 0, or more importantly about a point which is at rest, or otherwise you can always safely apply the equation of the torque about the center of mass. So in this case there is no problem, we apply the equation of torque about this point to get. First, let us find out the moment of inertia of this rod. The moment of inertia of this rod about the center point will be ml square by 12. You must remember these values of moment of inertia because you cannot proceed without them in these type of questions. There will be many questions in future, therefore it is best for you to remember all the values of moment of inertia of various things. Just like I will tell you one more, always remember that the moment of inertia of a uniform rod hinged at one of its ends of length L and mass m is ml square by 3. If the same rod is hinged about its center, the moment of inertia becomes ml square by 12. So in this case, we know the moment of inertia to be ml square by 12. The mass is 1 kg, the length is 1, therefore this is equal to 1 upon 12. So we remember the moment of inertia and we write the equation as net external torque. This alpha is inside, so we write the inside torque first. This tension T2, let us draw the rod. T2 here, T1 here, since tension is always a pulling force, it rotates like alpha in this direction. We rotate our hands in direction of alpha, we get alpha inside. This tension is trying to rotate the rod in the clockwise direction again. So this is in the direction of alpha, therefore T2 into 1 by 2, that is F into R perpendicular, minus T1 into 1 by 2. This is because this tension is trying to rotate the rod in the opposite direction of alpha. So what we have to write is always the net external torque in the direction of alpha is equal to I into alpha. So we can write this safely as 1 upon 12 into alpha. So we get T2 minus T1 is equal to alpha by 6. So we get the three equations we needed. 5g minus T2 is equal to 5 alpha by 2. T1 minus 2g is equal to 2 alpha by 2, and the third equation is T2 minus T1 is equal to alpha by 6. On solving these three equations, these three simple linear equations, you can solve to find out alpha is equal to 8 radians per second square. You can also find out the values of tension in two strings that is needed. Then tension comes out to be 27.6 newtons, and tension T2 in the string joining 5 kg comes out to be 29 newtons. So our final answer for the alpha T1 and T2 is I here.